everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I want to show you a nice sort of summery lightweight project which is fantastic for your sort of hand dyed yarns. Now if you're anything like me, I absolutely cannot resist an amazing skein of skein. How do you say it? There's a question straight off the bat. That's got absolutely nothing to do. I'm going to go with hank when I get a hank of hand-dyed yarn. They're beautiful. And I'm really guilty of never using them or never having that perfect project, like the project that's good enough for my amazing hank of yarn. So I've gone with a really, really simple project for you in the form of a shawl. Now, this is the one I'm currently working on. I am using sock weight. So it's like a fingering yarn, I think, light fingering. It's very, very fine, as you can see. This colorway is called PRISM. I bought it from Snufflebean Yarn. I will link to it in the description box below because I believe she may still have a few of these left. Don't quote me on that though. You might want to move quickly if just in case she doesn't have any left. This yarn is gonna go for miles because it is sock weight, so you always get great meterage in sock weight. You can do this shawl in any yarn weight that you like, any yarn, any hook size. I just wanted to show you what I'm currently working on. For the sock weight and this shawl, I have been using a 4mm crochet hook. Now, I have already blocked this little bit. It is quite slow growing, obviously, with it being the sock weight yarn. And I was impatient to show you because if we wait for me to finish this whole shawl, summer will be long gone and it'll be winter. So I blocked this, and by blocking, what I did was I pinned it out onto some foam mats. I lightly sprayed it with some water and I left it to dry. So as you can see, it's held its shape. It's gone quite big already and I've not really used that much of the yarn. So you can see it's holding its shape nicely. It's got really, really lovely drape to it. It's nice and lightweight. It's the perfect sort of summer, throw it over your shoulders to keep the chill off. And of course it makes the hand-dyed yarn just sing. It's so pretty. I'm really pleased with this. So for the purposes of the tutorial, I won't use such fine yarn because obviously you won't be able to see what I'm doing. So I've grabbed from my stash a ball of the Red Heart Super Savers. I think this is retro stripe. Does it tell me? Yeah. Retro stripe, which is the most vivid sort of, makes me think of like, ooh, sherbet, what are those sweets? Refreshers. Makes me think of refreshers. So I'm going to show you how you make this shawl using this yarn because it's nice and big and you'll be able to see exactly what I'm doing rather than this beautiful fine delicate sock yarn here. But as I say, I just wanted to show you how beautiful this looks, and it is built from the sort of peak outwards, so it's all done in one as you go. So little pointy bit here grows outwards. So that's enough of my chatter. I'm going to zoom the camera in a little bit so it's closer to my hands and we can begin. Okay, so with your chosen yarn and your corresponding hook size, you're going to go ahead and pop a slip knot on your hook. However you do your slip knots is totally fine. Then you are going to chain 5. And then you are going to slip stitch into that very first chain right next to the slip knot to form a little loop. So to slip stitch, you just pop your hook straight in, yarn over, pull through that chain and through the loop on your hook. And then you will have a tiny little ring to work your stitches into. So you're gonna go ahead and chain 3, which counts as your first double crochet. Then you're going to pop 2 double crochets into this center ring. So yarn over, go into the hole, yarn over at the back, come through, three loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. And again. Then you're going to chain two and put three more double crochets into that center ring. Chain two, three more double crochets into the center ring. And that is the start, the very, very start of how to do this little shawl. Now, if your little center ring bit is a bit gappy, you can pull the tail a little bit and it will sort of close it up. But later on, when you weave this yarn tail in and around, it sort of closes it up almost to nothing. You can see here on my sock yarn one, this was done the same way. I've woven the end in and you can barely see the sort of center hole. Round two. Chain one, turn your work, and you're going to slip stitch under the last two double crochets of the three below. So just pop your hook underneath the V's of that second double crochet and slip stitch, and the same again into the third double crochet. Just slip stitch, and then slip stitch into the chain two space. So you've crept into this first sort of corner space. Now you're going to chain three, which counts as your first double crochet. And into this chain two space, you're going to put two more double crochets, chain two, and then three double crochet, all into this same chain space here. So I've got my first three stitches, chain two, three more double crochet, all into that same space. Chain five. And then into this second corner space, you're going to put three double crochet, chain two, three double crochet, all into that same chain two space. So it's looking a bit square and blocky at the moment, but bear with it. It turns into a beautiful triangle. So chain one, turn, and then slip stitch into the second and third double crochets from the row below. So I'm just creeping along and then end with a final slip stitch into that chain two space. Chain three, which counts as your first double crochet, and then pop two more double crochets into that chain two space. Chain two, three double crochets back into that same chain space. This is how you're going to work the sides all the way up your shawl. Then chain five. and single crochet into this chain five space from the row below. Just single crochet. So just pop your hook into the space underneath that, yarn over, come back through, put a single crochet in there just to secure it. Chain five. And then into this chain space over here, three double crochet, chain two, three double crochet. All into that same chain space. Okay, so it's a really simple repeat. I'll show you again, and this is what you'll do ad infinitum until you are till you are done. You're going to chain one, turn your work, slip stitch under the second and third double crochets and into this chain two space. Chain three, which counts as your first double crochet, and two double crochet into that chain two space. Chain two and pop three more double crochets into this chain two space. So you're always forming the sort of corner up the side. Chain five, single crochet into this first chain five space, chain five, single crochet into the next chain five space, chain five, and then end on three double crochet, chain two, three double crochet, in that final chain two space. And that's it, a really, really simple, easy repeat, which grows with these lovely sort of nice edges. So it's almost like a granny square corner on either side. So you would chain one, turn, slip stitch, slip stitch, slip stitch, form a corner, and then it's chain five, single crochet, chain five, single crochet, chain five, single crochet, chain five, all the way over to the other corner where you end on that same sort of corner formation. Now, this is working great in this sort of quite thick, heavy. Actually, I will do another row whilst I'm talking, just so you can see more what I'm talking about. It's working really well in this sort of heavier yarn. It's sort of been quite well defined, particularly those chains. The chain spaces are sort of sitting apart from each other quite nicely. Now, when I did it in the sock yarn, my chains all sort of lined up on top of each other, so it definitely needs a blocking if you're going to use a really pretty lightweight yarn, as Steve clearly agrees with me and has quite a lot to say today. She is such a pain when I'm filming, so I do apologize. There's only so much I can edit her out, so she's a very demanding cat. But as I was saying, with the sort of lighter sock weight yarns, the chains sort of sit on top of each other, more flat like this, whereas a heavier yarn, obviously it's going to pull itself out with the weight of itself. So if you were going to use something like this Red Heart, which is slightly stiffer, slightly thicker, you may not even need to block it. I don't know. But with the sock weight, you definitely need to. So I may do a video on how to block items. There's many, many different ways you can block. You can steam block, you can wet block, you can do what I did earlier, the sort of spritzing water over it. There's a lot you can do. It's very simple. And if you've never blocked anything before, sometimes it can really make or break a project. So, actually it is starting to do it slightly. They're sort of sitting like that. And it did that with my sock yarn. One all the way up. They just sort of sat on each other, but I've blocked this and look at it now, it's holding its shape beautifully. So it's actually quite resilient because I've handled this a lot as well. I'd have expected it to be crushing back down a lot more than it has done. So you can sort of see if you block it and pull it out and pin it into place, you get this beautiful scalloping. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I apologize for Steve and her general demanding loud shoutiness. I'm gonna go ahead and sort her out. I'll read that as boot her out of the house so she stops interrupting my filming. If you have any questions, by all means, shout in the comment section below. I've written the very basic sort of guide for how to do your row repeats and whatnot in the description box below too, so it's worth clicking that arrow, expanding the box and reading all the information about where I got my yarn and the pattern, etc, etc. It's all down there. And whilst you are down there ferreting around down here, it would be awesome if you hit that subscribe button as well so that you would be alerted every time that I release a new video. So I will see you again soon on my channel for another crochet tutorial. But until then, happy crocheting. Bye.